Hi, this is Jay Aaseng from Twin Peaks The Return. You're listening to Inspirado Projecto.
Oh, I'm dreaming of a purple Krampus, just like my neighbor once encountered. Long ago, at midnight, while he thought his children slept tight, those rascals were thrown into a bag. To be fair, they were nasty and rude. They were teepee houses and slash tires too. Oh, oh, oh. On that Christmas long ago, right there amongst the snow, they thought the sound on the roof were hooves from Santa's reindeer coming down there with a satchel full of toys. But those nasty boys were wrong, oh yes they were, as they screamed and kicked their way out the door. Cause Krampus has his own meticulous list of every child who's been evil through the year. So let this be a lesson to you and your children. That Santa might not be the only one visiting you on Christmas.
So we're here at California Adventure, waiting in line at this Little Mermaid ride.
Hello, dear looks like friends. You're about to go under the sea. So for your safety, please remain seated with your hands, arms, feet, legs, flippers, and fins inside your clamshell. And keep an eye on your little ones. They can't be everywhere you go.
Para su seguridad, por favor, permanezcan sentados y mantengan sus manos, brazos, pies.
So this is my mom's first time being to any sort of Disneyland thing. Today we're exploring California Adventure. Last time we were at a Disney place, it was Disney World, probably 30 years ago, perhaps. Are you excited, Jen?
Go on. I'm very excited, yes.
To go underwater?
Yeah.
Are you ready to explore under the sea, Mom?
I am really excited. I can't wait.
You're going to keep your tentacles, flippers, and wings inside the...
I'm going to try to, yeah. I'll do my best.
We got to keep everything inside the clamshell. So we don't... I'm getting the idea that there might be some various creatures. Mom just ate a churro. So did Jenny. This was a 5-minute wait time, which is great. Right after this, we got our fast pass for Soaring... I think it's called Soaring Over California or something. So we'll be checking that out soon. I think it's some sort of like IMAX experience. We'll be back later. As if we are underwater. There's cool, there's a breeze, there's a coolness all around. There are fish above us. Oh, Jen, look up above you. It's crazy. It's crazy. Amazing. Look at that, all the little fishies. Oh, look at that. All right, more on this later.
They're serving cold drinks today.
Yeah.
Hot drinks.
Here are your peanuts.
Yeah.
Stand in line for Soarin' right now. We had the fast pass. They let us.
Cookies. Well, I think the chips will get dip, but since you don't have dip, I'll have cookies.
So, Mom, what things do you think we're going to be soaring over today?
Well, I'm hoping the ocean, and we'll see some, maybe some whales down below, and porpoise.
Oh, so we'll soar above and under.
I think so.
Well, yeah, whales great. Come up, you know, they come up out of the water.
Oh, that's true.
That's what I was thinking of.
Oh, I see.
We might be soaring over Catalina Island.
That'd be good. Trees, Jenny?
Maybe some forests.
Oh, good. We heard rumors of orange groves.
Orange groves would be, yeah, that'd be nice. Maybe the redwood.
Yeah.
The redwood trees?
That would be nice, yeah.
The smell of trees? The hearty smell of trees?
How about snow on mountains?
Do I have any single flyers? Anyone traveling by themselves? Single riders? Any single riders way in the back?
A lot of us. We're going to be soaring over some skiers, maybe?
That would be good.
Snow skiers?
Ooh. So maybe we get some flurries of snow in our face?
Yeah. I don't know. It's an adventure I have not taken yet.
I think this will give me a lot of ideas for the next Bloody Bobby 5D experience. Okay. What do you think, Jen?
Yeah. Yeah, I have to take some notes.
Jenny, after all, played the part of Bloody Bobby in our 5D experience. Oh, here we go.
Hi. Okay.
Whoa, I didn't see you there.
That's all right.
Where'd you come from?
Where'd you come from? That's what I want to know. I think that's a happy little couple that was in front of us.
Are these black lights?
Yes. No, I don't think so.
They look like they would be. Like when you smile and your teeth, like,
oh,
they really stick out.
What's white?
This stuff in the Little Mermaid ride was very bright. Did you notice that?
Yeah, I noticed.
The whiter parts on your...
Yeah.
Like your shoes probably would have glown a lot. Did you look at each other's eyes on the ride or teeth? Probably like,
I was hanging on to it. I could see it.
There's so much going on that ride. Soaring on a Sunday afternoon. More on this later. We just got off Soarin', and I'm still putting all of my guts are in my feet right now. They're still kind of reassessing my body. Now, Mom, I just want to point out some of these predictions that you came up with. We did see a whale, right?
We saw a whale.
We did fly over an island.
We saw a beautiful island.
What the heck else did you say that you were hoping we'd see?
Snow.
We did see snow.
Polar bears.
Oh, my God.
I didn't expect to see polar bears.
Didn't you say something about going up in the mountains? I think you said that before. So we did go up in the mountains. The Taj Mahal, you know what was so great was the smells of each of those places.
The smells were amazing.
And the wind that would come swooping
yeah,
in.
Yeah, the wind definitely came. Oof.
My feet are still tingling.
Yeah, from the desert.
Oh, yeah, the desert. That's right. We saw the desert. We saw
it happened so fast.
Elephants.
Taj Mahal.
We were right up there with the balloons.
Oh, my God, that's right. We were up there
with the hot air balloons. Yeah.
Were you scared at all, Jenny?
I was scared the whole time.
Yeah, she was scared the whole time.
Mom was very brave looking over the edges.
I was pretty brave.
I had to hold on to the seat and close my eyes at certain parts.
Kurt was very scared.
Yeah, I was very scared. I was screaming and yelling.
We were all screaming and yelling. I think
yeah,
we were
the only
ones.
Yeah, I think you're
everyone
right.
Everyone else is like, I've seen this before.
Yeah, been there, done that.
Been there, done that.
Done that.
Done that.
Been there, done that. Got to smell the freshness of the oceanics.
Yeah. Yeah, and then the grassy smell.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
The grass, that was beautiful. And seeing the elephants and the baby elephants running through the desert, that was really pretty. Yeah, it was really a cool experience.
Soarin'.
We saw more than I thought.
Soarin'. It pulls you right up to the screen, which is all around you. You could see all around you.
All around.
Oh, man.
Off the ground and you feel like you're flying, and it's incredible. Amazing.
If you ever had any desire to fly around, without the danger of actually squashing, it may feel like you might squash. Oh, I love that. They got their little bubble guns. It adds to the atmosphere.
Do you want me to get you one, Kurt?
No, thank you.
We should get him.
I gotta go get one of those fast passes. Do you want to hang out here while I go get one, or what are your thoughts? I mean, there's more interesting stores that you still have yet to check out.
Okay.
Bubbles are.
I'm on a mission to look for bubbles.
Yeah. Well, more later. So, Jen, we were on the Goofy Flight School coaster, which was very surprising, wasn't it?
Yeah, it freaked me out.
It was scarier than we thought, huh?
Yeah, I had to hold on.
What roller coaster are we going on now?
Incredibles.
And what are your thoughts about this one?
I'm a little frightened.
Good. I want to get the interview before and after.
Yeah.
Wait, you think it's going to be as equally scary as the other one?
It's going to be scarier because it's not like a little kid's one. It's a more adult one.
Oh, yeah. Do you think the fact that it was a tiny roller coaster, that it felt like it was rickety and we might fly off the tracks, might have had something to do with it?
Yeah, probably.
This one looks like a little bit more involved, huh?
It does, but I'm still afraid because I haven't been on a roller coaster in forever, so
yeah.
We'll see.
Do you think this is going to go upside down?
I hope not.
If it does, are you prepared for that?
I guess. I'm here now.
All right. Very good. We will report back later. So, Jenny, now that we're done with the Incredibles roller coaster, what are your thoughts?
I'm shaking a little bit. Oh, there's my mom.
And you kept your eyes closed most of the time?
Yes. I peeped them open here and there, but I didn't want to know what was going to come next. Because
oh, my gosh.
I figured it would be better that way.
Oh, my gosh. I thought it was so incredibly smart, the way that it was set up. It was so smart. And the way that the whole ride is basically you're chasing around the little kid who's, like, multiplying himself.
I wasn't paying attention to that. I had my eyes closed the whole time. Freaked me out. He was laughing and...
Oh, my God. It was so much fun.
Did you come down by the water?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You started off there, and then you're sitting there, and then it shoots you off. And then, what, we went up?
We unexpectedly did upside down.
Like, my nerves are... Luckily, you had bars you could hold on to, and I was holding on to those the whole time. I had my eyes closed, and he's just having a blast. He was having a blast. I was...
Oh, my God. It was so fun. We did the corkscrew turns, doing the corkscrew turns.
I didn't know... I didn't want to know what was going to happen, so I just...
Was this all the same?
Yeah, yeah. I didn't expect it to be, but the whole thing was connected.
So that was a long ride.
You going to tunnels? Yeah, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, you go in dark tunnels.
And then you get in the water.
Yeah, ow, my.
You get wet?
Arm hurts from holding onto the handle so hard. No, we didn't. I thought we'd get splashed over there, but we didn't. No, I was quiet the whole time.
Oh shit. Jenny was quiet the whole time.
I can't believe it.
And they got our pictures, and Kurt's like this, and my eyes are closed.
Oh, yeah, I'll show you the picture. I'll show you the picture.
I know things.
I'm eating some carrots here at the Pacific Wharf area of California Adventure. And, there's some mariachi folks walking up, and one of them has very, very white paint on her face, and it made me think of a really interesting thing to see, like a gothic mariachi band, gothic mariachi. Like Tim Burton-esque, very slow down.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls.
Oh, here we go. We'll play one of them. We'll play one song here. Here we go. You can't go past the Let you know, Bradley Cooper is here at Cars Land walking past us right now.
Hi, Bradley.
Many of you are wondering, are you going to go up and say something to him?
Disney kill you?
Would Disney kill me if I say something to Bradley Cooper? He's there with his little kid. He's going into, there he is. He's walking. Is he? How many people does he have in his family does it look like?
Like five or six.
He's got his little entourage.
Yeah, got his little family.
If we just shuffle in and pretend we're part of the entourage,
yeah,
I think that could work.
Kill you.
I'm like, I'm his accountant.
No, I just
who we brought to Disneyland for no reason.
That's right. Right. He's keeping track of our finances. Make sure we don't, go in the hole by buying too many ice cream sandwiches.
We're Disney under, what is it, Secret Service? Disney Secret Service? We're like,
oh,
no.
Yeah.
In disguise. Aw, oh,
it's
Bradley
okay,
Cooper.
I'm Disney Secret Service. Yeah. You
yes.
can let me in.
It's okay. Oh, just seeing him and waving at him and
that
getting
was
a head
great.
Nod.
That was great.
Yeah.
We were here at this moment in time when that happened.
I think I'm a
that's
Mormon
so kick-ass.
I feel like I was blessed.
I still need to see the Lady Gaga movie he's in that he put together.
Oh!
Did you see it? Is it good?
A Star is Born?
It's good.
Yeah?
I haven't seen it yet, but it looks really good.
Music,
I love Lady Gaga.
Music is phenomenal.
I should probably find my sister, my mom.
Oh, yeah, they went in that shop.
Oh, they did.
Go. Enjoy.
Really quick, are there any things you want to promote since we're on the air?
Clown Island. It's going to be at the last week of January.
Clown Island?
Clown Island. If you go on clubhousearts.com, and that's clubhouse with a K, Clown Island, it's going to be really fun, really interactive. It's going to be Survivor, but with clowns. Lots of audience interaction.
Very
good. It's going
to be fun. Any other little sentiments you want to add?
Let me think.
It's Cassie, by the way.
I'm Cassie. Just live life and don't care. Unapologetically you.
That's what it is. Are there any things you want to add?
Cassie's the best. And you should listen to what she says.
Any things you want to promote on your behalf or others' behalfs?
Go ahead and check out Fullerton College Theater Arts Department.
Yeah.
We have Thoroughly Modern Millie coming out soon, and then Macbeth shortly after. So come, they're doing Macbeth.
The name we shall never speak inside a theater space.
Of course, but we're fine.
We're fine.
Come check us out. It's a really great department, and we put on pretty good shows.
Oh, I love it. What would you like to promote?
I have nothing to promote other than myself.
Do it!
I'm Lauren Marone. If you need a designer, graphic designer, photographer, choreographer, let me know. I don't know how would you get in contact with me?
Do you have Instagram?
I do. I do have an Instagram. LO_MARONE is my personal Instagram. So DM me on there if you need anything. And also, I want to promote Saving the Sharks because they don't get enough love, and I love sharks, and they're dying out from, fishermen killing them for their fins and stuff.
Oh,
so save the sharks, man.
We got to get off the street.
I love it.
Here
I love it.
Racers.
Oh, geez. Here comes some cars. All right. Anyway, it was great seeing you all. Take care. Wowzers. See how magical things can be?
It is now 5 p.m., 5 being the number of synchronicity. I'm standing in line for Guardians of the Galaxy, and it's only befitting that I'm calling attention to five right now, because what you just heard there was, you heard Cassie, you heard Cassandra talk about her theater company, and this is what's crazy. So I was standing in, it's called like Pacific something, little area of California Adventure. I had gone a different direction than intended. And my sister and my mom and I were there. And I was standing there, and all of a sudden I hear, Kurt. And I look over. And there's Cassandra with her two friends. And they had just been talking about Black Pumpkin. She was just talking to them about Black Pumpkin. And they'd just been talking about that horror film Black Pumpkin, talking about me. All of a sudden, there I am. Seconds later. And I thought, this is absolutely miraculous. Then
a little bit later. So they say that they're going to go to that Incredibles, the Incredicoaster, or whatever that's called, the thing that Jenny and I were just on. And so I decided to go with my sister and Jenny, I mean my sister and my mom, over to the Cars Land, the Carsville. I was going to go hop on there was like a ride over there, like a Cars ride. And we're over there, and I'm standing on a corner, and all of a sudden I hear, Kurt, they call me again. I'm like, what the heck, what are you doing here? It was them again. And they had tried going to the Incredibles roller coaster, and it apparently it had broken down or something. It wasn't working. And, which is crazy, because I had just gotten off that ride. So they said it wasn't working, so they decided to go over to Carsville just to hang out there or whatever. And I'm like, this is just crazy. This is nuts. I said, okay, we got to get a picture. And to capture this moment in time. So that's up on the Instagram account right now. If you want, you can go check it out. Go to Instagram.com/InspiradoProjecto, and you will see the photo evidence. And it was funny because as we're talking, all of a sudden this like parade starts going down the street. But as we're talking, they're like, is that Bradley Cooper behind us? And I look over his shoulder, and there's Bradley Cooper with his family. And I thought, oh my God, I really would, you know, I was thinking, oh God, I'd like to interview him for the podcast. And while I'm trying to get stuff together, other shenanigans happen, and he's whisked away. And which is interesting, because I've been seeing trailers, I've been hearing a lot of people talk about this movie that he's in with Lady Gaga, where I guess he plays the music, he sings songs in this movie. And so I said, oh, well, you know, I plan on going to the Guardians of the Galaxy ride, forgetting, of course, that Bradley Cooper actually did the voice of Rocket. I think that's his name. The squirrel, or not squirrel, raccoon, Rocket raccoon. He is no buffoon. He's in Guardians of the Galaxy. So they said that they had a fast pass to go on to this Guardians of the Galaxy ride at 4:30, and so I came by at like 3, and then the fast pass thing was going to be for like 7. I'm like, oh, forget that, let me just see if I could just go stand in line and just wait. And it said there was an hour wait. So as I was standing there, all of a sudden they ended up walking up. I'm like, whoa. I realized, oh my God, it's like 4:30 all of a sudden. And because some kind of little show went on out in front with a guy who looks like the guy from Guardians of the Galaxy and a woman who looks like the green-faced lady from Guardians of the Galaxy. And they were out there like doing some kind of dance or something. And it had just ended. So my mom and Jenny and I were out there watching it. And then after that ended, then Cassandra and her friends end up walking past, and I'm like, oh my God, what's going on? It's you guys again. And so I was debating whether I was going to go on the ride or not. I didn't know if my mom would have been up for standing in line for an hour. So I didn't know if she'd be up for that. So I told him, I said, I don't know if I'm going to be, you know, I don't know if we're going to be able to stand in line or not, whatnot. And Cassie's like, no, it's worth it. You know, just standing in line is an experience itself.
So, which brings us to this point right now.
All right, got it.
The my sister and my mom decided to not stand in line after all. So they're out there doing who knows what, but I'm decided to stand in line. I figured that since while I'm here, I might as well podcast, I might as well get the ambiance, you know? That's always what's fun about this, is you get a chance to hear all the different sounds, all the different, you know, what would normally sound like a, you know, like a Foley if you go into like a sound studio when there's like Foley art happening. This is the real deal. These are the you actually hear the ambiance. You get to hear what's going on. And there's no telling what's going to happen in any second, which is extra exciting. So, I had to tell that full story. I cannot remember if I told that story in a previous segment or not. However, if I did, it's worth repeating. Oh, and you know what? And let's just point out the fact that I'm standing in line at Guardians of the Galaxy, for crying out loud. Galaxy. The whole cosmic experience. Okay, more later. Well, they let him sit in?
Sure.
What's the name of their band again?
Ramsey Lewis Trio.
Ramsey Lewis Trio. And they would play it on Rush Street?
Yeah.
How did you first find out about them?
I don't know. You heard about them. We used to go hear different drummers, you know, different big cool bands like that.
And how many times would you say that you've seen them play?
Oh, several. Nine.
That's cool. Just to think that they had stuff recorded and...
Yeah.
And what's also cool is that you remember this song, you know? Yeah. Like, this specific song. How many songs do you think that they had? So the name of that song we just heard was called In With The In Crowd?
That was a short for In High Fidelity.
The In Crowd, you said?
Is next.
That's so cool. That is so cool. Wow. Out of all nights, you know, we happen to be here driving with this song. It comes on the radio.
Yeah. I think that happened another time with Mom. Some song came on. She's like, oh, I used to see that band. Wasn't it some other one? I don't remember who it was. And you said... They played, didn't one of them play at your school or something one time, Mom?
Yeah.
Your prom or like something?
No, at the Crail, at the school. The Crail was where we used to have bands and, you know, we had music and, you know, they just play music, we dance.
Then you were saying the Crail is where they would actually broadcast it live?
Oh, no, that place, that was at the, that's where we went dancing on Sundays.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
That was at the Willowbrook. On Sundays, they had a thing like American Bandstand.
And that was the place that burned down, huh?
Yeah.
And how long did that go on for with this on the Sundays with the American Bandstand kind of thing?
A couple of years. My freshman and junior year, or freshman and sophomore year.
Oh, so you didn't recognize it happening after that?
No, I don't. I think they stopped it after that. So we'd go and we'd be on TV, and it was like American Bandstand.
That's crazy. So you had to make sure that you were dressed real, you know, to the nines.
To the nines.
Yeah. And if you could
Yeah, or maybe take some dance lessons before you went.
Oh man, those have gotta exist some. They had to have recorded that somehow.
I just went because I love to dance. I didn't care if I was on TV or not. I danced every chance I got.
Wow. It'd be so fun to find out who's in charge of that stuff and who the camera operators were. And
he used to go with me. Jeez, there were a bunch of us.
Wow.
Maybe kids from different schools too, not just ours.
So you got a chance to meet all the kids who go to the other schools?
Yeah.
That's cool. So you were saying before that James Brown came out to, it was the chorale?
Yeah, the chorale. What a wild guy he was.
And then you got the chance to meet him, right?
Yeah.
That's crazy.
I'm not sure what he said because he talks so goofy.
Nah.
You know, he had like that Jerry curl hair going.
Was it after he had played the show and he was hanging out and talking to people, or was it before?
I don't know if he was hanging out talking to people. He was talking to us because Denny had something to do with lining up the show. I don't know what.
So we're going to 10. That's incredible. You got a chance to meet him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the fact that he played it, I mean, at your high school, basically, right? What other bands that you remember played at the Corral that were out, you know, and known and big? Shadow Knights?
Shadow of Knights or Shadows of Night.
Huh.
Something like that. That one you knew the girl's father.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, gosh. Clark? Dave Clark 5 or something?
No, Dave Clark 5 didn't play. That wasn't the band. It was a different one. Dave Clark 5 was...
Did you say, was it like Paul Revere and the Raiders? One of those kind of guys?
They were all popular at the same time.
Mm. Gosh.
She was staying at Alden?
The mom was, yeah. I was taking care of her when I was at CNA.
Wow. of all places.
Yeah.
She was staying there.
That's what I said.
Wow. And then,
get back on 5 months or what?
Yeah.
I said, well, then she was lucky she got me for her CNA.
That's right. Yeah, that was good.
We just came from this way.
Well, I got off. I didn't know where I was going, so I just kept going. And I...
So we're back on schedule.
So we did just come from this way.
Yeah, now we're getting on a different street. 7.8 miles, Route 34 west. Sometimes you just get...
Yeah, I know, but people come out, and it's like, just go, girl!
So, I had this idea for, Space Bakery at Donuts. Astronauts.
Yeah,
astronauts who make, donuts. One thing that, I'm sure a lot of folks echo this sentiment. And if not, it doesn't even matter. What I need to do, what I realize, is work. Work on my skills at going out into crowded places. I grew up with these principles of give and take, consideration, the golden rule, being aware, and when you enter spaces where you get the idea that maybe people were not taught those concepts, those ideas, those sentiments, and they just walk right at you, they're just cut you off. There's this idea of me first, over and over and over again. What's interesting is that it kind of inspires you to become sort of more fluid, and you know, it's like a symbolic representation of being able to change your path at the last second and yet still somehow get to where you want to go. And I suppose that's where the surprises end up. You know, these kinds of moments where frustration and tension and anger can build up in a person. You know, these are the moments where you... You really offered the opportunities to practice what you preach and put into practice the principles that you've learned about how, you know, all these people are a reflection of you. When you're driving through a parking lot, like we just were, like you just heard the frustration, you know, there are quick decisions made. People speeding around corners, cutting you off, pedestrians who know that they have the right of way out here in California, and so they'll walk very slow in front of you or right across from you, or they'll stand behind you while you're trying to pull out of your parking space. Little things like that. And I cannot tell you how often the most vile things can enter one person's mind while they're in that situation. It's weird. Around the holiday seasons, we're given this idea that it's joy, that it's, you know, love, excitement, and then we hear about Then we hear about how, you know, people, mothers are beating each other up over Beanie Babies or Cabbage Patch Kids or Tickle Me Elmo, whatnot. That sense of desperation, that sense of fear. Oh my God, am I going to get one? Oh, I promised little Johnny I was going to get him one. And then you got on top of that, the store's exploiting that fear, exploiting that that desperation, that, oh, you better get it now. Little Johnny isn't going to love you if you don't get this right now. I do extract myself from a situation. Jenny and my mom were over. I made the agreement to go with them to go Christmas shopping for stuff. And it teaches you a lot about yourself. It teaches one about themselves a lot, about what they're willing to, what they're willing to tolerate. What can add to a situation? You know, I think this is one of the reasons why, this is one of the big reasons why I don't want to have kids. I'm not planning on having kids. If I can't handle my own impatience, how can I handle being, you know, handling another kid's, another person's impatience, particularly when they're a little kid and they can't reason? You can't reason with them. And then you got the commercials telling them, hey, buy this, buy that. And they go to school and they see all the kids with this stuff and they go, well, I got to have one. And then how do you teach a kid that it's not necessarily the toy that's being played with, it's the value that's being placed upon the toy? And, you know, how do you explain to the kid, oh, you know, the Matrix, this is how the Matrix is. They're trying to lead you to, you know, a kid can't understand these kinds of things. And so it's just really, really intriguing to apply these concepts that you learn. Being patient with others, viewing them as reflections of yourself, viewing them as beings of life, beings of light that are all from the same place. And, you know, it's not that you're disgusted with the person, it's you're disgusted by their actions, and then you're choosing to be disgusted with that. And then you wonder, okay, well, what's the better outcome? What's the better option? What's the option that makes you feel better in dealing with this particular moment in time? How do you walk through life as like a monk, letting things just like that stuff, you know, that you can spray on your windshields and then the water just beads right off it. It rains and it just beads right off it. How do you become that? Or just beads right off you? And then you go, oh, it's just an illusion. You know, is the point of this journey to just simply the excitement of, like, my mom's in town? Let's just enjoy each other's company the best we can. And, you know, what do you do in those situations when there's those certain buttons that are pushed?
when you're hanging out with your loved ones. And then everyone's got, you know, similar reactions to that. And you try to hold it together. So, I'm very curious. Very curious. I'd love to know what some of these spiritual teachers that I've listened to how they react in these kinds of situations. Where, you know, they're thrust in the middle of crazy holiday shoppers and or crazy drivers. How do you keep your cool? How do you keep your calm? How do you do that? How do you do that? It's an interesting... I can definitely understand why, you know, that necessity of not wanting to go out has invented the idea of, you know, Amazon.com, Postmates, Uber, you know, just taking you right there. Let them deal with the driving. Let them deal with delivering the food to you. It makes sense. It makes sense. Oh my God. I'm at Michael's right now. And I see a 110 sheet sketchbook for $5. Are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? This is astounding. These things are huge. 8.5 by 11. Wow. Like, look at all these journals and sketchbooks. An astounding amount of journals and sketchbooks for these low prices. That's so crazy. I just saw this sketchbook here. It says it's just a phase. It's got the universe on it. It's a great reminder. You know what? You're bigger than all this. I think I needed to see that message. When you're around a series of minds that are stuck in a matrix, stuck within the you know, the bubble. Sometimes it's tricky to remember your greater, higher self when there are a majority of other... Look at this. Do more of what makes you awesome. That's a phenomenal message right there. Let the adventure begin. I need space. That's cool. I need space. All these things here I'm noticing are reflecting the stuff that we're just talking about here. Throw kindness around like confetti. Wonder what would happen if we saw more and more of that stuff. Find joy in the ordinary. This is good. These are sentiments that I need to be reading right now. And to implement. And of course, I'm looking at all of these art supplies and I got a buttload of them that I haven't even utilized yet. So that's another reminder of, like, you know, before you buy new stuff, do something with what you got. Interesting, there's a henna kit. I was just thinking about henna. Wow. Wow. Just incredible. Just incredible.
I just need to get all that, just exercise it all. So, it's probably something in there that resonates with you. It's funny, because this is just one moment, an entire series of moments. Look at that. Here's a shirt. There's a picture of this thing that says, I donut care, D-O-N-U-T, donut care. What did I just say in the car? Because we passed, what was it called, Krispy Kreme donuts? My mom said something about that. And I love how it was spelled D-O-U-G-H-N-U-T-S, donuts. D-O-U-G-H. And then that's what gave me the idea of coming up that idea, donuts. The Intergalactic Bakery. Donuts. Oh, my God. I love it. I love it. For the cosmic being within you, donuts. If anyone wants to make a bakery with me, let's do it. Donuts. Contact me at inspiradoprojecto@gmail.com. There are no shortages of ideas here. Let's be the first intergalactic bakery, shall we? Target right now with my mom and Jenny doing some Christmas shopping. There's a man yipping and yapping. Maybe you can hear him in the background. It's quite intriguing. Oh, there it is. Was we were over in the men's section. Some guy with his dog ended up walking through. Walked into the section with his dog. It was a service dog, and the dog heard this guy yipping and yapping, and then the dog started barking. So every time the guy went yip, you'd hear the dog go ruff, and then every time you'd hear the guy go yip, you'd hear the dog go ruff. So it's an interesting ping pong of sounds. I just had to get a quick field recording of that for you. I wanted to share that with you.